Hi, today's lesson is for February the 11th. Let's get started. Hello, boys and girls. How is everyone today? It's my job to keep you safe, and it's your job too. Move your hands with mine. I am a masterpiece, unstoppable, strong and brave, irreplaceable, cherished. I am a musician. Let's get started. Let's look at our first activity. You're going to have a partner, but I want you to see how it's played first. Okay? So this is head and shoulders, baby, one, two, three.
Go. Head, shoulders, baby, one, two, three. Head, shoulders, baby, one, two, three. Head and shoulders, head and shoulders, head and shoulders, baby, one, two, three. Knees and ankles, baby, one, two, three. Knees and ankles, baby, one, two, three. Knees and ankles, knees and ankles, knees and ankles, baby, one, two, three. Well, I ain't been to Frisco, I ain't been to school. I ain't been to college, but I ain't no fool. To the front, to the back, to the side, side, side. To the front, to the back, to the side, side, side. Milk the cow.
All right, so it's going to be clap, right, clap, left, clap, both, okay? Head and shoulders, baby, one, two, three. Head and shoulders, baby, one, two, three. Head and shoulders, head and shoulders, head and shoulders, baby, one, two, three. Okay, so practice that with me. So we're going to go head and shoulders, baby, one, two, three. Head and shoulders, baby, one, two, three. Head and shoulders, head and shoulders, head and shoulders, baby. One, two, three. Now on the I ain't been to Frisco. So you're going to go, I ain't been to Frisco. I ain't been to school. And then when it comes to the front, to the back, to the side, 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 you're going to hop to the front, hop to the back, and then to the side, 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 you're going to hop, hop, and hop. Okay? And then you start all over with the different motions. All right? So find a partner. Let's get ready. Here we go. You're also going to touch your knees and ankles, and then you're going to milk the cow. Now, here at school, we're not going to be actually touching our friends, but we will be playing.
Here we go. Head and shoulders, baby. One, two, three. Head and shoulders, baby. One, two, three. Head and shoulders, head and shoulders, head and shoulders, baby. One, two, three. Knees and ankles, baby. One, two, three. Knees and ankles, baby. One, two, three. Knees and ankles, knees and ankles, knees and ankles, baby. One, two, three. Well, I ain't been to Frisco. I ain't been to school. I ain't been to college, but I ain't no fool. To the front, to the back, to the side, side, side. To the front, to the back, to the side, side, side. Milk the cow, baby, one, two, three. Milk the cow, baby, one, two, three. Milk the cow, milk the cow, milk the cow, baby, one, two, three. Round the world, baby, one, two, three. Round the world, baby, one, two, three. Round the world.
All right, have a seat. We are February is Black History Month, and so we celebrate it in music. There is a special type of music, a special type of song called spirituals that they're not just regular songs. They have hidden meanings in them, okay? So stand up and move with me. Get your hands ready.
Train is a-coming.
Oh, yes.
Train is a-coming.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. At. Oh, yes. Sing the oh, yes with me. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Job. Have a seat. So let's take a journey on the road to freedom. Okay? Excuse me. So, runaway slaves used a very important network called the Underground Railroad. It's not an actual railroad like you would get on a train and then you would travel over rails to get from the south to the north. But it was considered a railroad because they used the terms Underground Railroad because at that time you could talk about it and people wouldn't think anything of it. And it was just a network of people that would help, that didn't think slavery should be in existence. And so they would help the slaves escape from, give them shelter, give them a place to stay, give them food, give them clothes, give them something to drink on their journey, okay? So it was escape routes that led from the south through the northeastern states and eventually into Canada. Its conductors were different people from various religious and ethnic groups, and they worked together to help slaves to freedom. Levi Coffin, a Quaker originally from North Carolina, he was named the president of the Underground Railroad by angry slave owners because of his desire to help slaves escape to the north. The Underground Railroad started to exist in 1830, and it ended in 1865 because that was the end of the Civil War, and that's when slavery was abolished or gotten rid of, okay? So if we follow the escape route for Wilmington, so if we start here, in what direction would they travel, and what transportation would they need? So they could travel this way. So what would they need if they're over water? They would need a ship, right? And then they would get up here, and they would have to travel on foot, okay, by walking. And there are people that would help them along the way, okay? So train is a coming, oh yes. Remember in the opening song, train is a coming, oh yes. That's talking about the meaning in that song is the Underground Railroad. So that means whoever is singing that is there to help the slaves escape. And the slaves could sing these songs when they were working without worrying about their owners thinking they were going to escape, okay? They wouldn't get in trouble because the owners would just think they're talking about regular railroads, right? So let's answer some questions. A place where runaways could find food and shelter is called A, a plantation, B, a safe house, C, a farmhouse, or D, a homeless shelter. Okay, let's see. I think it might be C. Let's check. Nope, it's not C. So plantation is where they worked. homeless shelters didn't exist then, so it has to be B. Okay. All righty, let's move on to the next question. This was a large estate or farm in the South. A, a villa. B, a horse farm. C, a plantation. Or D, a mansion. Now, a mansion is a large house. Nope, it's not a mansion. Horse farms did exist. No. Let's see if it's C. I wonder if it's plantation. Yes. The plantations were the large estates or farms in the South where slaves were purchased to work the land and work in the house. Many people helped runaway slaves escape to freedom on A, the Underground Railroad, B, subway, C, horse and carriage, or D, express railroad. If you said A, you're right. The Underground Railroad is the path that was used to help slaves escape. A blank would guide runaways as they traveled on the Underground Railroad. Would it be a conductor, B, a master, C, a foreman, or D, a farmhand? If you said A, you're right. Now, songs have different messages in them. So, Swing Low, Sweet Chariot, part of this song has been traced back to an African folk song. The chariot was the Underground Railroad. Harriet Tubman was a blank. What do you think? Conductor. Home was freedom in the... They wanted to go north, right? In the north or in heaven when they finally died. Carry Me Home has been thought to be a request by the slave to take him or her to... Coming for to carry me home, sweet glow, sweet chariot. Coming for to carry me home. Back to Africa. They wanted to go back to Africa because that's where their family was. That's where their friends were. Okay. Harriet Tubman would sing this song as she approached the nearby plantations. She hoped that slaves who wanted to escape would hear the song, gather their belongings, and secretly prepare to flee from slavery. Love that song. All right. Now, Wade in the Water is a very important song that slaves would sing, and they would sing it to help the folks who were escaping. It was a warning of upcoming danger. So let's listen to it. So bloodhounds, when slaves were escaping, slave owners and bounty hunters would use bloodhounds to pick to track the slaves to find them. Bloodhounds have an extremely good sense of smell, but even better than most dogs. And so they were used to pick up the scent of the escaping slave. By waiting in the water, the slave would throw the dogs off their trail because the water would literally wash away the scent. So then the dogs could not follow them because their scent was gone. Okay, just a couple more. This song was especially important because it gave them directions on how to get where they're going. Slaves knew that the North Star was found at the tip of the handle of the Big Dipper. They knew that if they followed the North Star, it would lead them north and to freedom. It's called the Big Dipper because it looks like a dipper. So follow the drinking gourd, a dipper that you would use to scoop things with. And so at the end of the North Star, at the end of the Big Dipper, at the end of the handle, was the North Star. And so follow the drinking gourd. Slaves, before they became slaves, Africans made their eating and drinking utensils out of gourds, which is a type of plant. So if you think about it, squash is a gourd. So they would cut the top off, clean it out, eat the insides, and they would let it dry, and there you go. They would have a bowl or a cup. A pumpkin is a type of gourd, okay? So let's listen to this song. Stand up. And move with me.
Freedom if you follow the drinking gourd.
So the song gave instructions to the slaves. For the old man is a-waiting for to carry you to freedom. That is talking about a conductor. When the sun comes up and the first quail calls, follow the drinking gourd. So it's telling them to follow the North Star. And it talks about the river makes a mighty good road, because if you follow the river, it heads usually one direction south. So you know if you're going against the flow of the water, you're heading north. And it talks about there's a type of plant that grows on the north side of the trees, of the trees, and it tells them what to look for in the song. All right, so that one is a very, very important song. It gives them directions. All right, so our last song is Go Down Moses. And Harriet Tubman used this song extensively to help her free slaves. Remember, she did make it north. She did make it to freedom. But she put herself in harm's way to help other slaves. So let's listen to the song.
When Israel was in Egypt's land, my people go. Oppressed so hard they could not stand.
Let my people go.
Go down, Moses, way down in Egypt's land.
Tell old Pharaoh to let my people go.
My people,
let them come out with Egypt's boy.
Let my people go. Go down, Moses,
way down in Egypt's land. Tell old Pharaoh to let my people go.
Go down, Moses, way down.
You've got to tell
them,
let my people go.
All right, so in the song, let's figure out Moses. Who do you think Moses is referring to? Is it referring to the slaves, slave owners, southern U.S. where slaves were held, or Harriet Tubman? So Moses, remember in the story, Moses leads the people out of Egypt. So it's Harriet Tubman, right? I know you go in there. Okay, it is Harriet Tubman, even though it doesn't want to stay in there. All right, let's do this. So it is Harriet Tubman, so I'm going to put her in the box, all right? Egypt land, is that referring to the slaves, the slave owner, or the southern U.S. where slaves were held? The southern U.S. where slaves were held, right? Pharaoh, who do you think the Pharaoh is referring to in the song? The slaves or the slave owner? The slave owner, because this in the story from the Old Testament, and this is the slaves would sing about religion. They would sing about God, and so they would sing these songs. A lot of them had hidden meanings, so they wouldn't get in trouble by their masters, right? So the slave owner is referred to as the Pharaoh in the song. So the people are the slaves, right? All right, so I have one more thing I'd like to share with you. It is a lullaby called All the Pretty Little Horses.
Hush up, boy, don't you cry. Go to sleepy little baby. And when you wake, you'll have cake. And all the pretty little horses.
Locks and bays, dapples and grays. Coach and six are little horses. So hush-a-bye, don't you cry. Go to sleepy little baby. Oh, mother dear, where's your lamb? I left him down in the meadow. Birds and the bees singing in the trees. Poor little lamb, cried Mammy. So hush-a-bye, don't you cry. Go to sleepy little baby.